In this lecture, we will study electric dipole and effect of electric field on electric dipole. Here we see some examples also.
Consider electric dipole. Two equal and opposite charges separated by a distance, small distance, form an electric dipole. So here we have two charges, minus Q and plus Q, separated by a distance, suppose D. And O is center of that distance. And if we take this line, it is called axial line, and that is along the length of dipole. If we take another line that is perpendicular to the length of dipole and passing through O, that is center, it is called equatorial line. Now we define electric dipole moment. So what is electric dipole moment? The product of the magnitude of either charge and the distance between the charges is called electric dipole moment. So here electric dipole moment P is equal to Q into D, and its unit is coulomb meter. What is direction? Vector P is equal to Q into vector D. Vector D is directed from minus Q to plus Q. So the electric dipole moment, it is along the axis of dipole and directed from minus Q to plus Q, that is negative to positive charge. So here P, it is directed from minus Q to plus Q. If we take suppose electric dipole whose center is fixed, and if we apply electric field, it oscillates in the electric field. Now we'll consider effect of electric field on dipole. For this purpose, we'll consider two molecules. One is non-polar molecule, another is polar molecule. Now if we see, this is non-polar molecule in which center of gravity of positive charges and center of gravity of negative charges coincide. So there is no separation between them. So net dipole moment is zero. If we take polar molecule, center of gravity of positive and negative charges, they are separated. So it has inherent dipole moment directed from minus to plus charge of the molecule. If we place non-polar molecule in the direction of electric field, there is effect on the center of gravity. Positive charge center, it moves along the direction of electric field, and negative charge center opposite to the direction of electric field. So the molecule is extended and dipole moment is induced, and that dipole moment, it is along the direction of applied field. While polar molecule, it has its inherent dipole moment. When placed in the external field, it is direct, that molecule, it is oriented along the direction of field, means dipole moment is oriented along the direction of field. We will consider example. Let us consider CO2 molecule. In CO2 molecule, O atom has negative charge, this O has negative charge, and this C has positive charge. And if we see dipole moments, we have two dipole moments, P1 and P2. So net dipole moment is P is equal to P1 plus P2 vectorially, and P1 is equal to minus P2 because they are equal and opposite. So net dipole moment is zero. That's why this molecule is polar, non-polar molecule. If we place this molecule in the external field, we get effect like this. Positive charge, it moves along the direction of electric field, and negative charge opposite to the direction of electric field. So due to that, P1 and P2, they are affected. P1 increases and P2 decreases. So P is equal to P1 plus P2, and that is not equal to 0, because P1 vectorially is not equal to minus P2. So resultant dipole moment is along the direction of electric field. So P is along the direction of electric field. If we consider another molecule, H2O molecule, here center of gravity of negative charges, it is on the O, while center of gravity of negative charges, positive charges, sorry, it coincides at the center. This center, it is on the line joining two H atoms. Now, if we see, these are dipole moments P1 and P2, and net dipole moment we can obtain by using parallelogram of vectors. This is net dipole moment. It is directed from O atom to base of H line. So P is equal to P1 plus P2 vectorially, and this is non-zero, so it is polar molecule. So H2O is a polar molecule. Now if we take this H2O molecule,
now we consider,
apply external electric,
non-polar dielectric material in the form of a slab. Non-polar dielectric material means it is made up of atoms of non-polar molecules. So here this is slab, and these are non-polar molecules. And if we apply external field, dipole moment is induced in each molecule along the direction of field, and here these two cancel with each other, these two cancel with each other, these two cancel with each other. For this positive, there is no cancellation. For this negative, there is no cancellation. So here this is net effect. So this surface on which we get net positively induced charge, and on this surface we get net negative induced charge. And due to these induced charges, inside the material electric field is set up. That electric field is from positive induced charge to negative induced charge, and suppose that is E dash. So there is net electric field inside the dielectric material, and that is from this surface to this surface, and it is along the direction of electric field. Now if we consider dielectric slab which is made up of polar molecules, each molecule has its own dipole moment, and if we consider whole slab, dipole moments of molecules are randomly oriented, giving out net dipole moment 0. But if we place this slab in an external electric field, dipole moments are oriented along the direction of field. And if we see here, the net effect for this layer of charges, there is no cancellation. For this layer of charges, there is no cancellation. So we get here net induced positive charge on this surface, and net induced negative charge on this surface, and electric field is set up inside the dielectric material from positive induced charge to negative induced charge, let it be E dash. So we have effective electric field E inside the dielectric material. E is equal to E 0 minus E dash vectorial. Now we will consider polarization of material. We have here dielectric slab of cross sectional area A and length T. So its volume is A2. If we place this in the external electric field, positive charge is induced on this surface and negative charge is induced on this surface. So net dipole moment, it is P is equal to Q dash into P, where Q dash is induced charge. Then we define electric polarization vector, that is capital P vector is equal to net induced dipole moment upon volume. So magnitude Q dash T upon AT. So it is Q dash upon A. Thus polarization is induced charge per unit area and its unit is coulomb per meter square. So polarization of polar dielectric material. So if we place dielectric material in the electric field, so we have two parallel plates. This is connected to positive, this is connected to negative. So electric field is set up between these two plates and this dielectric slab, it is inserted between two plates. So E is applied field. I have D and P. P is called electric polarization, this is inside the material. E, this is effective electric field, it is net electric field, and D, it is called electric displacement.